Like, video games always have like two or three really technical stump section that everyone struggle, and then the rest is like just fun and fast and cool to ride. Now it's like pretty much all the way down a little bit. We're gonna puzzle.
The track has some pretty deep sections, which are now just one massive rut. So they've made a new section, but they're gonna have to maintain it because it's just gonna be unrideable if that rut just gets deeper.
He had a set on his Heckler, and he said that he really, really liked the feel at first. So we put some XDRs on, and he liked them initially, but he reckons the XTs, because of the added material in the lever, it's actually like firmer feel. It's the start of the week though, so it's the track's going to change. He's going to change his thoughts and feelings on the matter. The puzzle can be real. He knows what he wants, and 9 times out of 10 he knows he goes in the right direction first try as well.
Hey lads, we are Never Gang World Champs 2020, and here's Lourdes Vergier race bike. Let's check it out. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Every race, there's like special things going on.
I really like those new Fox 40 mudguard. Like, they are wide, they are really well designed around, but I think the front is too front.
Just a few little more and then we're good.
He just can't help himself.
Monsieur Bricolage, you know Monsieur Bricolage?
I think it's the name of a hardware shop actually. But that's what I call him, because he just can't help fettle and tweak and... What do you play to wake you guys up at 8 a.m?
It's an old mate, Sean Paul.
Oh, oh. In love, the one be falling like this.
There you go.
Put your pressure in my adrenaline. Baby girl, now you don't already win.
Let's go.
Forecast is snow.
I was expecting to kind of build up into this weekend. Then we got the message last night saying that, you know, finals don't happen, they take volleys.
First few runs were like really tricky. I crashed a couple times. Still struggling, like food out and stuff like that down the bottom. It's not ideal. Like one big rut and then pick your, yeah, the one who puts his feet, stay on the pedal is like the fastest kind.
There's a few sections that really lose the flow, which make it quite difficult. And it's those sections that I'm trying to get around. It's a big scale electric down there.
I really like it. Like, there's some sections where there's like lines where only a few guys can do, which I feel like it's been a while since we've had a race or like had a track like that.
Not bad, is it? Better than it is on the dance floor, isn't it? It's racing smart in this sort of thing.
Yeah, like literally I thought, oh, 60% are gonna crash. No, 97%.
Yeah.
97.
Fuck. Solid, brother.
Yep.
90% of juniors crashed. Yeah, PA! It's nice now. Yeah, it's warm and hot down here, but the bikes are still muddy.
To be only 3.8 down when you've been on the ground, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
You've been cut.
Where'd you crash, pal?
After the steeps up in the woods.
You all right? You're only 3.8 down with that crash.
On its foot, zipper up at the moment.
Like Peter Norton's going to be the 10 next seconds, rider to cross this zone.
Don't get too bummed, just get refocused for Sunday.
Keine Fehler bei Fight 2, Jumpy, oben schon 6 Sekunden Vorsprung. And he takes the lead.
Not bad, kidder.
wear your masks.
Hopped the triple, landed and went.
Been red for the South African all the way down, and he goes into 11th place.
Second last.
Greg just came down, dropped into 11th place.
The only bit I could push really was the bottom.
And this is big name. Finish second.
So you were 9th at the first split, 3rd, 2nd, and then 11th, where you've obviously had your crash at the bottom.
Man.
Well, you were right there.
I was a bit hungry up there, because it was later. Okay. So I had a little piece of banana, and I think it worked.
Yeah. You were hoping for snow?
I was like...
Of course you are, don't even... Just admit it.
I was like, today I'm going to have a good run. Because tomorrow is like practice.
Don't even fluff it. Fuck yeah, he wanted to snow.
There's a few keys to unlock this section, but the best key is to get set up over this side, over this biggest stump, pop really close to that red pole that's up right there, and there's like a triple kind of. It's a really tricky move to do. There's only a few of the top guys making it look okay. Well, he went the wrong way at the end. He needed to turn right.
We square this one to be too tight. Actually, you need to stay like, to go to that turn.
Some carnage.
Gain quality. Just went from inside. The higher you jump, like the better angle you have on that pole.
There's not a consistent line yet, so it's a fine one. First time, perfect landing backside is out of here. Second time, you saw what happened.
It snows like hot, but yeah, no snow on the track, just mud and water. Nothing major, like it's been quite sleek already, so it won't change that much, I think. Yeah, like two runs probably, and then it's gonna be another champery, I think. It's some spot actually not too bad. Some other are like pretty bad.
I don't know what to do, I'm like stuck here.
Oh, this is hard. Like this bottom section is just like so deep. Yeah, just gotta try and like keep moving forward.
He's good, I think. I think yesterday was a good day. He'd been saving a few lines. He basically he said, if I do it on the first day, I've got to do it for 4 days. Whereas if I do it 2 days in, then it's only got to do it for 2 days. He's not daft.
Yeah, it was like snow and like survival mode down the bottom. But yeah, gonna be definitely one of the hardest races ever.
And it's snowing. See you down there. Yeah. Focus top to bottom, yeah?
Yeah. Five.
Oh. Fucking, he's never jumped it from that line, he went for that line.
What is for the boy?
Where is it? I know. You're not the only one that's happening to you though, so.
Good until that first stump bit, not the hard stump bit like
no,
that.
Yeah.
Couldn't get my foot in for the next bit, and then I crashed and it was over after that. So I feel embarrassed.
There's way worse than you coming down there, but I know how you feel. It's gonna be one of those, it's fucking weird. Come on, lad! That's not snowing as much as top. Gotta get this line. Oh. Come on. Get it.
Oh no!
No! No!
He's taken
Fuck!
Got both feet out. Fuck! I think it's got stickier. Once your feet were off in that bottom wood, it was like, fuck, just trying to get going. I got into the start gate, prep was good, warm, everything. I look out, the snow's coming in, so it was like, oh, this is incredible. Came through that first section and I blew both pedals. Managed to recover pretty good. I thought, okay, cool, now let's start going. I just started pushing in the main part of the stumps because of all the rain and snow that falls down. It's not really clear where the line goes. And so I'd come in and as I went over that stump, I was probably like an inch too far left, and then I missed the catch on the other side. And then I was like, I don't have the setup to do the triple out. So I thought, let me go for it anyway. And I turned to go look at it, and I can't even see it. I don't even know what to go for. And then I just did a big bowl of spaghetti onto my back. So I picked up like as quick as I could and got going. And I thought, shit, I could actually catch up this time. And I couldn't, I went down again. So it was hard. I mean, but you know, like when you look back at Rhys, Trimmer and Remy Therion, those guys look good in practice all week. So it's no surprise to me that they're on the podium.
First part was like, mwah. The other one was like, and the last one was like,
no celebrations for the Syndicate. Looks like we have to drink ourselves into a stupor.
COVID test. They jab a fucking stick up your nose about that long. Both noses. The first one I did, I was excited for because I didn't know what to expect. But after you've done one, it's like the dread just sets in.
It looks empty, and then there's like a big table where they fill up stuff. The first two times they broke like a skin or something, just kah! And now it's just like smooth, like butter, just.
Steve told me today, he's like, Luca, I think you need to work on, you know, getting up to speed quicker first run. Like, you know, you always just take too long getting up to speed. Like, you know, come out first run,
swinging.
And I fucking almost killed myself straight away. And it's so fast, like so
fast. I didn't realize how fast it was.
And I didn't ride here that last year, so I don't really know the speed or the lines. And I was like, right, I'm gonna make Steve proud here. And I just like, I need to slow down. But then it took me like two runs to like figure out how to ride it, and then felt really good at the end, so just ignored Steve's advice and carried on like I usually do, and here we are.
Yeah, back in the rain. So rainy race. We got a starter pack going on the rainy race. So basically, it's a big old XL fender on the front. Metallic pad without fins. I think, let's see with the boss what he says. And yeah, probably ask the guy in front and the other two in the rear, just same as yesterday. Because there's so many roots and everything, so you want to keep the grip on.
We're going to leave the four.
We're going to leave the four.
I think we should go 3-3.
Why?
I haven't figured out why, but I just feel it.
Oh, I think if anything, if you're not sure, we go shorty front and leave the rear as a compromise.
So we'll make a decision in 5 minutes.
But Luke is on drive, DHR's in, to front rear.
You have to display.
All I can do is give you the information. It's got to be your decision.
I just don't feel entirely confident like pushing the limit when I don't know what the track's like, so just having an internal battle really. Like, don't want to make mistakes, don't want to crash, but if you ride like that, you just are off the pace, so yeah, it's hard, it's fucking hard.
How's your German, pal? We've got a pub, patio heater. Want a bit more of a pub vibe in the pits. Just for me, not for riding.
Yeah, so he scores all his runs on effort. And yesterday's quality run was a 6 out of 10, which is pretty steady given that, like, at a test trip, he's usually riding at 7s and 8s. So I would expect him to go a little bit harder today.
Wynn also said there was little dry bits coming out on track and it's really good, like, the whole way down, so you can push.
1.1 up.
He's got power, really, on legs.
But he has, big time. He just needs to have more faith in himself.
1.539 up at the second split. Come on, lad. Yes. Luca, 2.5 up at the third split. Bring it home, bring it home. Luca Shaw coming into the finish line. Yes, Luca. Good luck.
That's like one of the better runs I've had in like shit conditions like this.
Greg, 0.3 up at the first split. So close. Greg, up 0.03 at the fourth split. So close.
We've got 5 riders left, and Greg and Luca are still first and second.
Laura Serge on track, 0.1 down at first split. Will was pushing then. 2.6 seconds up on Remy Tiron. We've still got Greg in third, Luca in fourth.
One more. Fuck yeah, we still got it.
I didn't know Reese wasn't riding. I was like, another one.
Yes, man.
You can be bummed for a little bit, but you rode mint, so fucking
yeah.
Not too long.
That was sick. Everyone's pinned. It's good.
Good.
Congratulations!
24 carat plastic.
Mine's bigger than yours, bro.
Do you think I can keep it? My wife would be really proud. She loves all those trophy. Can drink the vino.
How many DMs? We'll see tonight. But I just want one from someone. Ah, she did. Ooh. Second of my career. I'm happy. This for the first time. And then we need to move on, it's already like
race.
No rest, big day tomorrow.
Trying to count and you disturb it. Oh, was that down the inside? Was that my line?
We just raced and now we pretty much racing again. Also it's points, you know, so you have to, I need to be on it. I can't afford another 20th.
yeah, it's just trying to get those new sections right, and then one or two neaten ups on the main track and blast it again.
A little bit of pasta.
That's good.
Is that the last time you wore it, when you stole it from me?
We need to find some second car.
Slowly drying out. It's a big steep hill and it does dry quite quick, so when we walked it late last night after qualifying, there was a couple of dry patches coming out in the woods where they dug down to like real dry stuff. So overall the track was getting drier, because when it gets to finals later on, there'll be minute gaps between all the girls racing now. There'll be minute gaps and then 3 minute gaps when the fastest guys are racing, and in those 3 minutes track gets to dry out a lot more because tyres aren't on it constantly, so it's gonna be good for the boys later on.
Getting hand pumped. It's the best day ever. Actually that'd be weird, but yeah.
Well, Greg's in gate, I think.
Down to hold on, because we've got some winter telly. Pin it!
Yeah, that's good, because you don't usually have the best start, so... Come on, nail these rocks. Got it!
Look,
got
at it! That.
Split coming up! So tight, though. Get that triple. Yes! Easy. Bring it home, so...
Fucking
pedal! Nail that first split. That's a solid up. Nice. Yeah. Bring it home, kiddo. Fucking pedal. It's gonna be so close.
I wasn't like flowing good, but I was like pushing hard. And then at the bottom, I hooked the turn and like lost my foot. I definitely left some time up there, which is annoying, but I thought I'd be further back, so. We'll see how we end up.
Nice! Come on, Loris. It looks a bit tired. Come on, Loris. Pin it. Pedal! Not by much.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
I'd like to know if it's the tightest like win ever or not. 0-0.
Yeah.
5.
Yeah.
It's like either way I was happy, like it felt just, you know when. Yeah, bro! I'm coming back.
That would be like.
Merci beaucoup! Almost didn't win.
Almost, but almost doesn't count.
I talked
to. You sponsored this.
Jordy's gonna do it.
Oh, there's a hair on my leg.
First time ever, number one, numero uno. Yeah, it looks like is a one to watch, you know, when he's riding down there. It's like, ooh, watch out. With the yellow, it's like, ooh, even more watch out. No, he's chill. He's just gonna try to win it and twice, and that's it. That's what I want to do. Oh yeah, last bit gonna be hard. Like, imagine all that track, just dead and got to pedal those jumps, like those step up and uphill jumps. Oh,
yeah, good luck, guys.
We wanted to go up a standard long, not a long. So 460 on the XL frame. Just because there's a few sections at the top to the bottom that are like long rhythm sections, and he reckons you can generate more speed with a shorter rear end.
I was kind of surprised after the first run. I had a few greens and I was like, well, that's weird. So like, let me have a full run and just, you know, see if I'm up to pace or whatever, and ended up being up to pace. So I was pretty stoked with that. Then also surprised where I lost them. I lost like almost a second and a half in one section. So it's quite a pedal down bottom there to those jumps. So I definitely like to be up there. You know, my aims are definitely podiums. Minimum. That's what I'm going for. And if I can get on the highest step to the podium, that'll be even better.
Book of knowledge.
My diary. Dear diary. Day 57 of summer camp. I don't know, man. I came in thinking like, oh, we've been here before. Like, I'm gonna be up to speed like that. But didn't exactly go like that. So no room to be conservative these days, that's for sure. And yeah, I was kind of pissed off because I was really close to having like really good results, but I was just off. So need to keep pushing, trying to get on the box. Sounds good, he says.
Made any tweaks on the bike today?
Many. Many tweaks from yesterday and today, but... same frame, same size, same wheel size. Different tires, so the HR2 on the front, as we need the rolling, you know, for the last bit and the top bit too.
Oh, fuck off.
We removed the volume spacer because before we had at 8, so the fork is real progressive, but because it's so steep, so it just, when your fork is real progressive and when you hit, it just comes into your hand like quicker. So Jordy Shaw made a new shot for us, like really light, like really supple, really soft. Different settings because he wanted more rebound to carry speed, but we opened high speed, but the high speed was too much, so we closed back high speed and opened low speed instead. We need to have everything, you know, perfect and set up.
Yes.
Hey. Have you done nothing?
I just pulled.
I mean, with the bike.
I just pulled the fork through.
I think it's fast, high speed.
Okay, just do one slow. Let's see what she does.
Yesterday, it was slow, high speed.
We don't have a lot of time.
I have all the time in the world.
Oh, she doesn't feel like much.
Go deep. Come on. I don't want to wear you out.
Go.
I think it's... I would open the low one and then leave it.
It's like major changes, you know?
I need your acknowledgement. I need to know that you're here with me.
You still haven't said, yeah, do it.
At least I've got
you
someone...
You need to blame somebody.
At least I've got someone to blame.
Have fun. Just gonna change it back as soon as he gets to the top.
I think it was good not to attack too much because the track was really tricky and like changing a lot, and a lot of like every corner you could see like skid marks going straight or off track. I was like, we all in top 10, I think.
Top 5.
I kind of like held back a little bit coming in all the turns and just like tried to ride smooth and clean. Yeah, pretty stoked. I was definitely surprised. Like, yeah, he was there. The bright yellow bike, I could fucking see it out of the corner of my eye, and then I heard him. So I was like, oh shit, coach is watching, better pedal hard.
It's
Jordy didn't mess it up, surprisingly. I lost a bit of time down the bottom, I think. Just as you come out of the woods, that feeling, but so I need to, you know, just pedal hard tomorrow. I think I got a bit lazy and I just shoved it in a pretty stiff gear and I just ground away. I actually need to just focus on powering.
Lauren first, Luca third, Greg fourth.
Boom, boom,
PA.
Boom. Fisting. You don't call it like this? What do you say?
Fisting.
You don't say fisting? Oh, I don't know. Anyway.
You fuck, how much space I do have?
93.
Okay, how many volume space left?
8.
So you're still at 8, okay. And high speed rebound?
5.
And low speed rebound?
6. On the first day of practice, the balance was all out, but because the berm's got the big holes in. But now they're on the insides and like low down, we've got softer.
Yeah, like we asked for softer valving shot, like really, really soft.
Yeah, this is open. Super light. And it's fresh oil, so now it's fresh oil, it's actually more open. It's going to be a bit slippery, I think, first thing. But I think by quali happens, by race it'll be...
Yeah. Like yesterday.
Yeah.
Probably only have time for 2, right?
Yeah, I think so. And I think you want to maybe try and save the body a bit as well.
Yeah.
Please. Come on. Come on.
I don't really want to.
Yeah, I know.
Just relax your arm. Come on.
I just feel like no one should touch any sweaty armpit ever. Like, you know, it's not something you do. Even I wouldn't touch mine.
A lot of people would love to touch your sweaty armpit, Loris.
I'm pretty sure it's not true. They're dribbling, so it's bad, you know? In the morning it gets like kind of moist. So don't know really what to expect now, like if it's going to be really dry or not. So just try to hit your line, trying to make no mistakes and pedal hard. That's the goal.
Public transportation.
Taxi!
8 a.m. Da da da!
Smash it. With a bit.
Some more. Well.
See it finish line.
Yeah.
So, this bottom bit.
Shit! Go on, son.
And now we need to push up.
He's
the
got a big time.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, bring it on, sir. Yeah, boy! Sent it! Fucking huge, man.
It was smooth, it wasn't good, I didn't feel good.
Oh, you're not going on this track though, you're not going to feel smooth and good.
Fastest I've ever seen him sprint ever. He's just got such a strong sprint. He's unreal.
Oh, Luca's down for... Fuck! He's slid out or something. He's fucking pulling it back. But... been down proper. Poor lad. Fuck, mate. Looks like he's got a problem. Fuck. Fucking Loris. Oh dear.
I hope Loris is okay. Yeah, I mean, it's devastating that he punched it, but I can't believe it.
He's always been a powerhouse, got a big engine, and he smoked him down bottom.
I lost the second and a half there yesterday. I was going to lose it today.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
I shit my pants. Well, that's normal. That was good.
It's not good for Loris's overall. I'm not sure after qualifying, but getting the front flat sucks. It's a bad way to lose a championship, but we've still got another race to go. We'll have to see how we go on.
Sorry I didn't stay. Yeah, it was bad for me.
Shame, man. Where'd you end up in the points?
I'm 15 back.
No, but today, where did you finish?
59. It's like front flat. And it didn't burp, so it was fine, but if I tried, it would burp.
Hey.
Good day for us, though.
Proud of you, though, still.
Fucking pin. Good.
Just keep it going. Go tomorrow.
Oh, 2 minute. I'm going to cry right now, I'm sorry. No, actually, like in 2 minutes, I'll be fine. Like in my racing career, like lows, and I really didn't really expect this one, so it hit like way harder. And I, you know, when you're coming down, starting realizing, and you don't want to see anyone down the bottom, and I feel bad now because fuck, like Greg won. I was mad. And Sunday we got it again, and that's the fight for the, I don't know, we'll see.
I just opened my phone. The up down side of winning. Sitting in the hot seat, one rider to go, and all that's going through my mind is Syndicate 1 and 2. And then I'm watching, and then he's punching, and I was just like, whoa. The technicians at Santa Cruz are loving it, because for years I'm pushing the areas of lengthening that swing arm, and you know, I go back to the stock one and suddenly I win again. So that's going to be a tough challenge to ask for a longer swing arm again. We're going down to one race. It's a bummer for Loris. He's had such a good pre-season, such a good season so far. It's unfortunate. Punch, I know what it's like, you know, that's what happened to me in 2017. He just gets head straight and focus again for Sunday.
Message from Steve. The hole is good, boys. Cheers, Uncle Steve. I guess it'd be concerning if he said the hole is bad. You didn't know which one he's talking about.
It's a bit of a strange one because it's double points in finals tomorrow, because this is effectively World Cup finals. There's no points in quali, so our boys are planning on having pretty solid runs, like on all the tech and all the good, so they can have good splits, but not really putting a maximum effort in at the bottom. Save a little bit for finals tomorrow. Fingers crossed.
I wanted to like ride well up top and then obviously take the pedaling easy. There's nothing on the line to push for. And then as I got into the corners, I just mistake after mistake and kind of got down the bottom, put a couple cranks and sat down and just pedaled. And yeah, in second, but it was an untidy second. I think Luke must have been practicing his luck out today. With the VPP, we don't need that shit.
Pretty good, like kind of one line. One little section that I want to go look at, but it's pretty, it's got a nice flow to it. It seems a little easier and smoother than the other track, so yeah, it's good. It's fun racing when you're, you know, feel like you could fight for the win. It's definitely it's a good feeling, so.
Don't. Nope.
This morning I was like trying hard to go fast. I think if the quality was like points, it would have been normal day, cool, but not the case, so I don't know how I feel about myself right now. It's like when you don't try, you're far and you're disappointed, but you didn't try, so it's like I'm scared now. So yeah, I need to find some seconds up there, and we'll see, try the best tomorrow.
Are we having a race day dunker? Because I've got the goods. Tea time! For our non-rich viewers, these are an absolute classic. Let me bring them over to you. This is your Crawford's custard crepe. Two buttery little biscuits stuck together with a bit of custardy cream. Can you hear that? Mint. Did it work? Ish. Flicking the page.
It's a huge day for the overall, yeah. I mean, no points in quali yesterday. Maximum points for finals today. 250 for a win, 200 for second. It's really tight between Matt Walker and Loris. Then you've got Greg and Bruni tied for third place. Luca is sitting in 10th overall at the moment, I think. So it'd be good if he could have a solid podium finish. Like, where's everybody going to sit and where's it all going to finish overall? So it's going to be a pretty exciting race day.
Friday definitely gave me an old spark that I can win, you know, a game. What really excited me was yesterday. I think that excited me more that I was on pace and, you know, there's quite a bit in reserve.
Let's keep it that way, huh?
That was his last warm-up and everything with us. I'm sad.
Yeah, it is sad. Loads. Yeah, and his noises and his farts and his annoying little sayings and the fact that he annoys the hell out of me. But yeah, I'll miss him.
Yeah. Don't, you're gonna make me cry.
You've got everything else. Yeah. All you need is a little luck. Yeah. You got all the skills. See you at the bottom.
Just started fine rain here now, like it's fitting down here, so it's not major yet, but a little bit of stress. Luca's off in about 8 minutes. It started raining a little bit at the top, like weather's come in, you can see mist in front of us there. Just hope it doesn't affect the track.
Well, I'm glad we have Luca coming down in a couple minutes, and then Greg's like 42 minutes after that, so we'll have a various conditions on the track at least.
Another American rider who's been really looking good here in Lousa. Not looking so good for him so far. 2:12.76 down already.
Oh, attaboy! Attaboy! Yeah! That's brutal.
Just everywhere hard packed is like ice. It wasn't really raining even, but it's just enough to make it really glassy. It sucks.
It's like nervous for the track conditions more so than nervous for them to perform. As now it's just like, come on, Loris, just go for it. Losing a little bit everywhere.
And the time just slipping away.
Oh, what an end to the freaking shortest season of all time.
It's like a sled, put a foot out, almost went over the bar on the high speed lift. Oh, what a race.
That's not the way any of us wanted to end it. Fucking rain.
The rain having its effect.
Doable. Fucking doable.
If anyone can, Gregory can.
Okay, first split coming up. Come on, Greg, you can do it. It's so doable. Come on, Greg. Come on, Greg. Come on. Jesus. Well done, man.
Surface still?
Yeah.
And it's so close like that.
But it's that close, yeah.
I hit my head out the start game. My goggles going my face. I couldn't pedal out the game.
You don't mind, like when you lose by a second or so, you go flippy, you get smoked. But when it comes down to like 0.1 of a second or whatever, you're like, that could have been the race. But, you know, besides that, I was stoked. I rode a pretty solid, smooth run. Got on that gas hard. But bloody hell, I lost it. 0.1.
Like when you realize your dad was a slut and had a bunch of kids, and one of them just comes into your life.
Yeah, could be true.
But then he gets a better job and he leaves. Every once in a while he gets drunk and texts you.
Yeah. It's been good, buzzing hard with him. And sometimes not so hard. Like, we found some good setup.
Finally.
Yeah.
Is 100% for the fans.
Actually, I've got everything sorted, just a lie.
I don't know what to say, everything's so good.
The team and like everything that standed for it was just everything you dream as a kid.
We're gonna make a great team.
And then when it's happening, you're like, wow. Like, I was just so stoked, and it's been 4 years now.
I think, I don't know.
Makes sense.
It's just my personality. Like, I change things quite often, and the team is just a crazy, like, you can be as crazy as you want in a team and be accepted. And I'm gonna miss you guys. I'm gonna come see you anyway.
I remember the first test I did with Loris. It was before he had joined the team. I was just so impressed with his riding, his style, the way he would set up and just carry great speed through the corners. It was so impressive to ride behind. It took a while to get to know Loris, and I really enjoy his personality and his quirkiness. This year was incredible to watch him. I have no doubt that he's going to have a great future ahead of him.
He smoked us this week. Well done, brother.
Oh my goodness, that is so good. Where'd you get that?
I like it.
When we like became teammates like 4 years ago, I didn't know him at all, and I actually didn't like him that much at all, because we were like competitors, you know, like since the fucking first day we were teammates and the first day we like properly met, like it's been honestly so good. And yeah, he feels like a brother to me, honestly. Like, now I'm stoked for him, and I think he's like fucking blossomed into one of the best racers in the world, and I always knew that he had that in him, so it's pretty cool to see. And really gonna miss the little fucker.